Joseph from the Jerusalem group is asking, how did the sages know that during the times of the Messiah, the insolence shall prevail? It is a process known to all. The Reshimot, they reveal from light to heavy, and if we don't correct them, and we can't correct them until we really reach the generation of the Messiah, then of course we will be in great insolence and the revelation of the tremendous will to receive. And we're only starting to discover this. What are we discovering? A bit despair, a bit cruelty, people are distancing a bit from each other, a family breaks up, education, something here, something there. It's not insolence yet. We don't see it that a person comes up to you, takes from you, and disregards you altogether. He steals. It's not even considered stealing. He simply disregards you. We don't see that yet. We see that the world is still hypocritical. It's not that insolence shall prevail. Insolence, it means that I do it and I take no one into consideration. As if no one exists. I don't even feel that they exist in the world. I don't feel them as human beings. My ego has grown so much higher than all the others. Then who and what are they? I don't even know that they exist. I can do anything. And it's not as a result of me fighting my shame. I don't feel the shame. I don't feel it. That means insolence shall prevail. Insolence, it is a sign of the extent of the desire, that it will reach such great dimensions that we'll have to nonetheless correct it.